I mean? When we come together like this, incredible things take place. See, we connect thoughts to collect shorts, and only the strong will survive. I love my black people. We are the future.
Versus somebody helping you find the money. Right?
So the loan officer finds the money, we find the property. You know, so it's like we can't necessarily do what he do, he can't necessarily do what we do, unless you switch your licensing.
I do have a question for you. For myself too, because I'm not the most knowledgeable of it. Can you explain the difference between like a loan broker and maybe dealing with a loan broker as opposed to dealing directly with your bank of reference, yeah, like Wells Fargo or Chase or something like
your
that?
Your credit union, for that matter.
Or your credit union.
Absolutely. Well, you're just talking about the difference between a mortgage broker and a mortgage bank. So a mortgage broker basically is shopping your loan to different banks to help you get, you know, the best deal or whatever based on the banks they have. A mortgage bank is basically a direct lender. Direct lender basically has their own money. So they have their own set of guidelines that are going to help you get you approved. So that's the main difference. You know, either you're shopping it to other banks or you actually are the bank and you're kind of fulfilling your own guidelines, so to speak.
So it's better to work with a mortgage broker, correct?
You know what? I honestly would say it really depends on your scenario. One bank may not have the loan program you need, and the mortgage broker may be able to, you know, get that program for you. Mm-hmm. Versus a direct lender, you know, their guidelines are pretty much straightforward. Like, you know, what they can offer is one, you're dealing with one bank, right? Mm-hmm. Versus a mortgage broker is dealing with, a lot.
Yeah.
But the mortgage bank also controls the transaction a little bit because they have underwriters in-house, processing staff, things like that. The mortgage broker is sending it to a bank, so they're not really, you know, involved in it beyond referring it out.
Mm. Okay.
Minus collecting documentation and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So if my mortgage bank is one of your mortgage banks that you use as well, would it be smarter for me to go directly to the mortgage lender?
It could be. I mean, you have
I don't know. I wouldn't know who your contacts and stuff are.
Let's say you're a mortgage broker and one of your banks is Wells Fargo. Okay. And I work for Wells Fargo.
Yeah.
I don't work for Wells Fargo. I work for Legacy Home Loans, disclaimer. But, you know, let's say that was the case, right? The rate I offer you direct from the bank, it could be better or worse than the rate you offer them as a broker. Because you might have certain kind of agreements with how your rates are adjusted or take a certain hit of your commission or whatever to kind of make the rate work for the client. Mm-hmm. So it really just depends. It could be better. It could be worse.
Now, I always recommend to clients, you speak with a mortgage broker, but you also look into your credit union, because sometimes the credit union has advantageous interest rates based on you know, the fact that your money's tied directly to them. Is that something you agree with?
You know, when you look at interest rates, and this is what people kind of miss the mark on, if you ask me, is that's not the biggest determinant factor sometimes when getting your offer accepted. Your interest rate benefits you as the buyer, right?
Okay.
But if you go submit an offer, and this listing agent, the person that controls kind of the transaction of accepting your offer, has never heard of this credit union, doesn't care about your interest rate, just wants to know if they can close quickly, if there's going to be any issues with what they call overlays, which are basically rules on top of rules that some lenders have. Some people may go with like a direct lender such as myself versus a credit union just based on the fact that they know that that's all we do, right? And your reputation and things like that for closing. So it's bigger than just the interest rate. I mean, what's a 4% interest rate if it ain't going to close?
Very true.
Good answer, brother.
Thanks for watching Real Estate Corner on the Millionaire Mindsets podcast. I'm your host, Anthony Tullis. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments, or you can DM me for more in-depth questions. I'll answer either way. I'm providing one-on-one consultations for all current and future homeowners. Can't predict the market, but you can get educated. Why not you? Why not now? Like, share, and subscribe.